will sing of praises unto my King, yeah.
I will sing praises unto my King, yeah.
He is creator of everything.
He is creator of everything.
I will exalt him, his name adore, yeah.
I will exalt him, his name adore, yeah.
Honor and reverence forevermore.
Declare that thy name is holy.
And I'll declare that thy name is holy.
Be thou exalted above the heaven.
Be thou exalted above the
heaven. And all thy glory above all the earth. Somebody stretch your hands and say,
adore you, cry out. We declare nobody like you.
Listen,
love you,
worship.
Adore you. We declare. Oh, 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 oh.
We worship.
Adore you.
We declare. Nobody, 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 nobody.
We worship.
Hello, and welcome to the City of Refuge United Church of Christ. I am Nettie Young, and I'm here to offer each of you joining us a warm welcome to our worship service. At the City of Refuge United Church of Christ, we are a ministry of restoration. We are intentionally radically inclusive, and we welcome all persons regardless of race, color, ancestry, age, gender, ability, sexual or affectional orientation. And we celebrate the Creator's diversity. We worship Christ, and we welcome persons from all faith paths which harmonize with the ministry of Jesus Christ. Reverend Dr. Yvette Flunder, who is the presiding bishop of the Fellowship of Affirming Ministries and senior pastor of Refuge Ministries, along with the pastoral team, an entire congregation, thank you for worshiping with us today. If you are a first-time visitor or have been away for a while, please let us know by typing hashtag visitor in the chat. Again, type hashtag visitor in the chat if this is your first time. Refugees, please show love to our visitors and welcome back to those returning. Thank you for being here. Please join us now as we go before the Lord to magnify Him and offer prayers for God's people in our community prayer.
And good morning, everyone. I am Michael Filigera, and I am bringing and leading community prayer this morning. Before I begin, though, I would like to just put a shout out and wish my pastor, Maria Caruana, a very, very, very happy birthday. A little bit of history. Maria has been my pastor for over 22 years. Maria was my pastor at Freedom in Christ. She brought me closer to Christ. She brought me closer to family. She showed nothing but love. She nurtured. She guided. And it is through that that my love for Maria has grown so strong that I will always say, Pastor, you are my pastor now and forever. I will always turn to you for guidance, for help, for support. And I encourage everyone to do the same. She's now a member of Freedom, she's now a member of the City of Refuge, and I am too, and it is through her that I joined this magnificent family. So again, happy, happy, happy birthday, Pastor Maria. I love you. I love you. And also, a quick shout out and a happy birthday to Mother Melba Jackson, whom we got the pleasure of seeing last night. It was fantastic to see you, Mother, and we thank you. We thank you for all that you share and all that you do. And now, to community prayer for today. In my prayer this morning, the Holy Spirit gave me the following. To stay focused, the winds of change are indeed blowing. And remember God's word, as in 2 Corinthians 1:20. For all the promises of God in Him are yes, and in Him amen, to the glory of God through us. So amen, I say, so be it. Let our amen make it yours. Therefore, trust God with your problems. Rely on God to fulfill His word on our behalf. As it was stated in Psalm 18:2, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. And now I'd like to share the prayer request that we received this week. We're praying for Nora Hausman, who suffered a miscarriage. We're praying for Cassie C., who has several health concerns. We're praying for Jules, dealing with mental health issues. We're praying for our brother, Sean Nunley, for healing from past church trauma and to embrace what is next. We're praying for family and friends of Eddie Alcoron, an educator in the San Francisco Unified School District. We're praying for our transgender siblings in Uganda, for their safety and their well-being. And we're praying with and for Pastor Cheryl Ward, who asked us, please have the church pray for me. My mobility is challenged and I restart chemo on Monday. Trusting zero side effects, her spirits are great. She just needs some pain relief. We're continuing to pray for Ray Richardson and his family in the passing of their mother. And we're praying for the families and other individuals bused and flown across the country by Republican governors using them as political pawns. And this morning, as we enter into prayer, let us go before the Lord and seek his presence. And let us ask through Jehovah Jireh, which translated is the Lord will provide. And also we go and we stand before the Lord and ask in Jehovah Rapha that God is our healer. As we stand and we pray with our brothers and sisters, Father, I ask that you only hear their prayer, but that they trust and they understand that so much is done through Jehovah Jireh. God will provide. God provides the comfort, the need, the relief from pain, the steady strength to go through the challenges that are being tossed our way. Father, I ask that each one of these prayers are on your agenda and that they will be answered. But Father, we pray today that through Jehovah Jireh, through Jehovah Rapha, that these miracles will occur. Miracles for pain-free. Miracles for comfort and understanding and peace for the times of trouble that many are going through. Through the comfort and the love and the nurturing that will be required as families grieve for their lost ones. For understanding and instruction for how and why things keep happening to those that are under siege politically. Father, it is only through you that our answers will come. It is only through you that we understand that so much of what is occurring is, again, as you tell us, to stay focused, that you remain on your throne, Father, that you are in charge, and that nothing escapes your notice. And that for every action, there is a consequence. But Father, thank you for reminding us that it is not us that need to have that consequence delivered. That we don't need to step in and to handle the battles that you are telling us do not belong to us. So Father, thank you for reminding us that the battle belongs to you. And that battle could be for our own health. But it belongs to the Lord. And if we release it back to him and we trust in God, in that his word is true and that the answers are amen and yes, then rest assured that it lies in God's hands. And it is through his will, through each one of us, that everything will be done. Father, we thank you. We thank you for hearing these prayers. We thank you for sharing with us all that will happen. And again, we approach and we stand in gratitude and in love. And we say, thank you. Thank you, Father. And we pray all of these in the most holy and high name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And now we move to the gratitude in giving.
Yes, and amen. Thank you, Brother Michael, for that prayer. I am Lay Pastor Tina Stewart Taylor, and I am here to do your gratitude and giving. Thank you, Jesus. As most of you all know, here at City of Refuge, we strive daily, even through this pandemic, as we're making our way out, to empower, enrich, and renew disenfranchised and marginalized communities, both locally and abroad. It is through generous donations from you, our family, our friends, our visitors, and our viewers, local refuge programs such as the Word of Mouth Food Pantry, which happens every fourth Saturday of the month. We feed thousands of families, as well as our LGBTQ and differently abled education and inclusion work, our national social justice, our equality activism through the Fellowship of Affirming Ministries, which is TFAM, as well as our missions and ministries in Mexico, Asia, Africa, and the United Kingdom, can continue to make room at the table for everyone there. We invite you to become a part of our efforts in providing practical, no harm solutions to critical community and world issues. No donation is too small to make a difference, and giving is simple. Ooh. You can use text to give by texting 510-257-9001. Enter the amount you'll like to give, press send, and follow the prompts through EasyTithe. Or you can use Cash App, which is $CORUCC, or PayPal at www.paypal.me/CORUCC. We thank you in advance for your gifts and for partnering with us and making someone's life brighter when things aren't so bright. I want to invite Minister Terry Wells to come and give a special announcement. You all have a blessed week, City of Refuge. Love you.
Amen. Mother, you're a special lady. You're a very exciting girl. Mother, you're a special lady. And you've got us sitting on top of the world. Sitting on top of the world. Mother. Mother, you know we love you. Oh, Mother, Mother, you're the queen of our hearts. Your love is like tears from the stars. Mother, we just want you to know, loving you is like food to our very soul. We love you, Mother Miller. Again, happy birthday. And this announcement is to everyone about last night. Amazing, amazing, amazing. And we just want to send out some shout outs to everyone who participated in making the extravaganza amazing. Amen. Especially to Gina and Sweets and Treats. Thank you so much for your contribution of making this event amazing. To Bishop Flunder, thank you for sharing Mother Miller with us. Even though we know, you share her with us, the gift that God gave you first. And we thank you so much for that. To every department, the deacons on point, The media team, amazing. Thank you so much. You guys are amazing. To the family for pouring in your love. We felt it all through the room on last night. Thank you. You are amazing. To the City of Refuge family, off the chart. You are beautiful. We as a family, thank you so much. T-Fam, you came through and showed out. We love you and thank you so much for your love. The breakdown and setup crew, delicious, off the chart. Thank you for your love. Thank you for giving us that City of Refuge thing, what we do. We appreciate it. All the contributions, all the financial blessings, all those things, that the late night prayers and the early morning worries and sometimes a little interesting dialogue, trying to make it be and have the spirit of excellence that it was. Thank you so much on behalf of Mother Miller. We just say thank you to everyone who contribute. Amen. Those who wardrobe, fashion people, all of you. Amen. The young people came through with some amazing gifts and treasures. Thank you so much for showing up and showing out. You were amazing. Amen. And in this moment, let's embrace some highlights from Summer of Soul, where Mother Miller received an Oscar for this experience, and just some other golden nuggets that has happened as a result of the excellence of who our Mother Miller is. Enjoy, and God bless.
Let me tell you, it was exciting because it was the beginning of our tour, the first tour that the Edwin Hawkins Singers was able to put together. I didn't even realize what kind of effect it was having on people at the time. It was an exciting moment for me.
Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day.
You know, from that time to this time, it's been a lot of living.
When Jesus was.
Singer! Can I have you on stage, please? Check one, check two.
So this is quite something. Harlem Cultural Festival was an exciting moment in my life. I was born in California, lived in California, and I was always here. And the only reason that I was out here was because of my cousin, Edwin, who asked me to sing Oh Happy Day, and the rest is history.
Festival performances finally being seen in the movie Summer of Soul?
Well, I think it's about time. And I think that the world needs to be reminded of what was going on in the world at that time.
Oh, happy day. Happy day.
It was a difficult time. And I think that to be able to sing a song that could bring people together made a huge difference in what was going on in the world.
Oh, yes, he did. The greatest day of my life was when the Lord came into my life. And he washed all my sins away. He'll do the same for you. Then all you've got to do is open up your heart and allow the Spirit of God to come in. Oh, when I'm in the heavens, I'm gonna spread the news.
Good God. Yes, oh, happy day. Oh, happy day.
We thank you for your gifts, and as you are giving, here are your announcements. Join us for our next hybrid service happening on October 2nd for World Communion Sunday. Register online at cityofrefugeucc.org. Digital equity is a civil rights issue. A new federal assistance program will help families in need get connected to broadband internet service at home. Save the date for the National Sign-Up Day for the Affordable Connectivity Program happening on September 24th at 11 a.m. through 2 p.m. Pacific Time. If you are involved in any of the programs listed on the screen, you qualify to receive internet service for free. Scan the QR code on the screen for more information or go to blackchurches4digitalequity.com. Join us at Yoshi's Monday, November 7th at 8 p.m. as Live Nation presents Pastor Bo Jackson and the Sounds of Life. Take advantage of the free monkeypox vaccination clinic happening on our City of Refuge campus. You may call 510-589-1262 to schedule an appointment in advance. However, walk-ins are accepted. Feel free to call the number listed for more information. Join us for a grant writing seminar free for City of Refuge members and leaders happening on Saturday, September 24th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Oakland Main Library Conference Room. Seating is limited. Please register. To register, contact Pastor Tony Dunbar at dunbart1@pm.me or text 415-728-1709. Refuge Remix, Sunday service remixed. Beginning in October, there will be a follow-up question and answer to the Sunday service. This will be happening on Tuesday evenings, times to be determined. Stay tuned for more information on this and find out more through our website at cityofrefugeucc.org. These have been your announcements, and again, we thank you for worshiping with us.
Happy Sunday, family. The choir is coming this morning with a song of God's great power. All through the Bible, there have been situations after situations where God has brought people out. Daniel in the lion's den. Joshua with the battle of Jericho, Jehoshaphat with the battle with the tribes of Ammon. God brought them out. And then there's the three Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace. They were not unstable because they knew that God was able. He will bring you out. Come on, choir. God bless you.
Story, and that's the word for me. for you.
Yes, they help you.
I know God will.
Yes, they help you.
I know God will.
Yes, they help you.
I know God will.
Yes, they help you.
Yes, he'll do it.
Yes, they help you.
Yes, he'll do it.
Yes, they help you.
I know God will do it.
Yes, they help you.
He'll bring you out.
Yes, they help you.
He'll bring you out.
Yes, they help you.
He'll bring you out.
Yes, they help you.
Yes, he'll do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm Pastor Maria, and I'll be reading our scripture for today, which is from 2 Samuel 6, 14 through 16, from the New Revised Standard Version. David danced before the Lord with all his might. David was girded with a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. As the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, daughter of Saul, looked out of the window and saw David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart. The next voice you'll hear is from our beloved Bishop Yvette Flunder with the sermon for today, When David Danced.
Praise the Lord, saints. Thank you so much, Pastor Maria, for this introduction. Thank you for the worship. God bless each of you. Thank you. Thank you for the music, for the scripture, for the songs, for the love that was expressed in our worship experience today. It feels so powerful to be a part of this community that we call City of Refuge United Church of Christ. And to all our folks, our beloved that are local, those of you that are all over the country and world, God bless you. What a glorious weekend we have had. I want to say also to all of the folk, if I start calling names, I know I'm in trouble, who contributed your time, your treasure, your gifts, your skills, your unfailing love for Mother Miller in the celebration of her 80th birthday. What a blessing. I told her I think that she's moving the clock backwards. I'm not exactly sure how that's working, but I can tell you I'm glad about it. I am so grateful to each of you, and I'll be able to say so personally much more in the days to come. But all kindnesses that are given to Mother Miller bless me in ways beyond words today. So thank you, and to my family, the King family, who were there in copious numbers, as along with the Refuge family, to Bishop-elect Vanessa, Bishop-elect Troy, who came all the way across the United States, as others also did, to be with us. Pastor Carol Houston, how beautiful, 80 years old. I'm a happy woman, I want you to know. So I certainly appreciate each of you. I wanted to share today from some reflections that have been on my heart and in my spirit. I want to talk about King David today. I say often this is the unlikely boy who would be king. King David today. And to share just a little bit about what it means to be unlikely and how important it is to understand that God will bless you no matter what your deficiencies seem to be to other people. If you personally are all in, I use that word all in, or those words all in, because they depict what it really takes for us to do what it is often that God has called us to do. All in as opposed to half in or sort of in. Or kind of in. One of the first things we must be clear about is if we are going to do the work of the Lord, we have to be prepared to be all in. Let's talk about this young man just for a minute today. David. He was young. He was what I would consider differently abled. Essentially, among his brothers, he was diminutive. He was smaller than his brothers, and perhaps considered weak. The other thing about him, in an atmosphere where it was important for men to be ruddy, to be powerful, he was considered handsome and beautiful. He was not what was considered good fodder for a throne. He also had some interesting experiences in his life. We all know the story of David and Bathsheba. And you know that he killed to have Bathsheba because he desired her. And then of Jonathan, who was the king's son before David, Jonathan, of him he said, "Your love to me was wonderful, surpassing the love of women." Yet David was such a prominent figure in the Old Testament. This allegedly imperfect human was anointed by God to save, to heal, and to rule among his people. And what I really want you to get on here is that he was anointed by God without question. He was anointed by God without question. King David, who was once a shepherd boy, who became Israel's third and most important king, he is the most frequently mentioned human in the Old Testament. And David is a main character in the Old Testament books, 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles. He is mentioned in several other books. And nearly half of the songs, are attributed to him. He was a songwriter. I wish often that we could hear the music of his harp, that we could hear the musicians play the songs that embraced and surrounded his lyrics. Nearly half of the Psalms are attributed to him. David, the boy who defeated a giant with a slingshot. In fact, the famous narrative of David and Goliath has been so prolific in literature and art and culture that it's become a common story for describing other stories about underdogs who are able to come up. Why? Because David is a significant biblical figure in his role in establishing the kingdom of God on earth among the Jews, establishing an earthly headquarters in Jerusalem. But most of what I want to share with you today, that despite his glaring flaws, David is described as a man after God's own heart. I'm talking to somebody today who may feel that because you have had glaring flaws, that you somehow cannot be a person called after God's own heart. David was far from perfect, but his faith and his zeal made him the standard against which all of Israel's future kings and leaders would be measured. I need you to hold on to that thought for a minute, because there are still some of us that are caught in what have been our past mistakes, what have been our training times in life. Because I'm going to tell you, and I've said it often, I'll say it again, I learned very little from my successes. What I learned really in life, I learned most often in my mistakes. As a shepherd, David didn't merely feed and lead his father's sheep. While a shepherd may seem like it's inconsequential to a position such as the one he came into, it was dangerous. What was powerful about his being a shepherd was he took what was perhaps considered his diminutive structure and body and strength, and he found a workaround. Somebody say workaround. I can't hear you, but speak it into your own atmosphere. Workaround. Workaround. He did not go after the beasts that came to kill his sheep the way that other people did. I need you to hear me today. He didn't take on the lion and the bear and the wolf barehanded. He didn't even take them on with a spear or a bow and arrow. He came up with something that he could use. I hope you hear me today. He became good with a slingshot. And he found out that if he could rightly find the good, solid, smooth stones in and around the area where he worked, and he could essentially put together, create a wonderful, powerful slingshot. What he could do with a slingshot was more than what some could do with a spear or with an arrow. Because that's what you learn when you are in an inconsequential position. As someone who is called by the divine to do things differently. David killed bears and lions alike to defend his father's sheep. He found a method that was unusual, but it suited his size and his skill. In fact, David cites his experience as a shepherd to convince King Saul why he could defeat Goliath. Listen to him. He said, King, your servant, he was talking about himself, has been keeping his father's sheep. You know, people look down on you when you're a shepherd among warriors. But this is what he said about himself. And I want you to put a comma right here and say to yourself, self-confidence is extremely powerful when you are othered by people. He celebrated his otherness. Listen to him. He said, King, your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. And when a lion or a bear came to carry off the sheep of the flock, I went after it and I struck it and I rescued the sheep from its mouth. And when it turned on me, I seized it by its hair and killed it. Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. And concerning Goliath, this uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them because he has defied the armies of the living God. And the Lord, who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear, will rescue me, will rescue us from the hands of this Philistine. And then he rejoiced and gave glory to God. And he went and he chose carefully the smooth stones and he prepared his slingshot. And with strength, this, the smallest of his father's children, stood face to face and hand to hand with what he could do, what many thought was impossible to be done. What he could do was what brought down the enemy that day. And when the victory came, like so many times that the victory came to David, he would play his lyre, his harp, and he would dance before the Lord. Even when King Saul was angry and frustrated, when things wouldn't go right, David would take up his lyre, his harp, and he would play, and relief would come to the king, and the king would feel better. This David, with that kind of confidence, this David, who took on a giant with a slingshot and smooth stones, this David, who was also a musician, this David, who loved both Bathsheba and Jonathan, this David said to Goliath, "You come against me with a sword and a spear and a javelin, But I come against you in the name of the Lord God Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. And this day, Goliath, the Lord God will deliver you into my hands. And this day, I will strike you down and I will take your head. And this day, I will give the carcasses of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals. And the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. And this day, all those gathered here will know that this is not by my sword or by my spear, but that the Lord saves. And this day, the battle is the Lord's, and he will give all of it into our hands. I need to talk to some Davids just for a few more minutes. Because when Saul ceased to be king, David, who served his king Saul, was then called to be king in Israel. And God testified concerning David and said, I have found David. This is what God said through the prophet. I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. David will do what I have called him to do. Yet some say, but he killed Uriah. And some say, and he stole Bathsheba. How could he be a man after God's heart? And he loved Jonathan. I need you to stop there and rest for a minute. Because it is fitting that David is such a prominent figure in the Old Testament. Why, beloved? Why? Because as an imperfect human, anointed by God, he had the human experiences that he needed in order to do the godly call that was on his life. Somebody understands what I'm saying. You've got to have some human experiences in order to do the godly call that is on your life. You can't help anybody. You can't encourage anybody until you have had some human experiences. Can I just tell somebody who may be having a human experience today? Learn how to clap your hands in the midst of your human experiences. When perhaps people have put you essentially a label on you that you are a failure. Learn how to clap your hands in the midst of your human experiences. Where someone says you're too small, you're too poor, you're too dark, you're too short, you're too gay, you know, you're just too. And you'll never be able, you see, the real fodder that feeds the power of God in your life is the beauty of your human experiences. David was all alone with lions and bears, but his job was to protect the sheep. And he learned something in those times when God came to his rescue, he and his slingshot, and he and his bow and arrow. God came to his rescue. And once you know God by yourself, once you know God when you're alone with God, then you can stand out on the field before Goliath face to face. Say to him that the God I know in secret is now going to evidence God's self in public. David was all in, and he did not view his otherness as a handicap. I want to say to everyone here today, do not view your otherness as a handicap. What did he have that made him find power in his otherness? He did not view it as a handicap. What shall we say to these things, beloved? If God is for us, what can possibly be against us? And may I say it in another way, that some of you all will really grab hold to. He knew he could slay. He knew he could slay. With his unique method, he knew that he could slay. He wasn't hindered by his size, by his age, or by his beauty. He was not concerned about negative opinions. There were times when he danced before the Lord after the victory of the army until his clothes fell off. And he upset the folks that were connected to him closely. They got frustrated with the, can you see him? He's the king. And he has danced out of his clothes. But I can feel him because I know something about this. I can feel him saying, in this moment, I could really care less what you all think about me. The Lord has delivered me. Why should I be bound? I am loved by God's own self. I have had provision given to me by the hand of God directly. God has once again given us the victory. I will dance. In fact, I love the song, when the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced. What does it mean? To rejoice with reckless abandon. Because God has once again come through for us. He danced until his clothes fell off. It wasn't something that he was doing for proper decorum. He was dancing before God because he knew that only God could have given him the victory. And like so many of us, his life suggested that he repented and recovered from his errors, not once. I'm sure that there are several times that he repented and he recovered from his errors. He repented, he recovered, he learned from his mistakes, and he moved on. And remember this, my beloved, my. Remember this. Jesus was called the Son of David. To this day, David is greatest, the greatest king in all of Israel. Jesus was called the seed of Abraham, but he was called the son of David. My question, what is our excuse for not being all in? What does all in mean, Bishop Flunder? Fully engaged in God's will for us. What is our excuse? I'm sick, I'm old, people don't understand me, I'm afraid, I'm not this person, I don't have these skills, I cannot. What is our excuse for not being fully engaged, all in? And if yours is a different skill, use your slingshot. If yours is a different way to show up, use your beauty. If yours suggests that somehow musicians can never be warriors, show people how we can be incredible, incredible, doing things that perhaps are not the social norm. Fully engaged in God's will for us. And let me close with this. Many of us use our otherness and past failures as an excuse for not embracing our greatness and our destiny. I want to come against that spirit. I want to come against it with as much power and grace as God will give me. Because it's time not for you just to recognize your otherness and your past failures, but to use them as the principal stepping stones for your greatness and your destiny. It is time to go all in, beloved. It is time to face every Goliath, to fully use and celebrate our uniqueness, and to embrace the challenges before us with confidence in the God that called us and chose us. And be clear, watch the spirit of defeat that will tell you when you run into a wall that somehow you missed God, that somehow God is not on your side. Listen, honey, let me say it to you clearly. If there's a wall that is there, it means one of two things. Either it is not the way that God has chosen and there's another way. Or it means that God is going to give you the power and the agency to knock it down or to climb over it. How do I know this? Because all things work together for good to those that love God and who are the called according to God's purpose. It's time to be all in. It's time to face every Goliath. It's time to stand on the field of battle, speak truth to power, start it in the mirror, and then take it with you everywhere that you go. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. God bless you is my prayer today.
My goodness, praise the Lord this morning. Thank you, Bishop, so much for that word today, for it's kind of a call to self, a call that is the call today to relationship with God. Be who God has made you to be. Glory to God. Thank you so much, Bishop. Wow. It's hard to do the invitation to others when I feel invited right now. Praise the Lord. I pray this message blessed you today. It is our wish here at City of Refuge to offer our best. It is our effort and our wish to offer our best in hospitality, community, and relationship. Of course, the greatest of these are those three things is relationship, and that's a relationship with your Creator. A question came up for me as Bishop was preaching. Have I taken on the voice of my accusers? They no longer need to say anything to me because I say it to myself in the way that I do show up or do not show up, the choices that I make. Can you relate to that? I just want to say that there is absolutely nothing that can separate us from the love of God and the call of God over our lives and our destiny. See, it doesn't matter your background, your education, your affections, your finances, your affiliations, your identification, praise the Lord, your gender presentations. Again, there is nothing that can separate you from the love of Christ Jesus. Now, if you are so inclined to go all in, to accept the offer of relationship with Christ, to accept the offer of manifesting who God has made you using the tools that God has given you and built into you that have been born out of your experience, we ask that you acknowledge your RSVP at this table of life with Christ by typing hashtag Jesus in the comment section. See, just hashtag Jesus, because it's simple. There's nothing left to be said when you call on the name of the Lord. Enter your call, and one of our ministers chat will be in contact with you. And we welcome you home. Sharpen up your tools and become a part of the body of Christ as never before for this time. As I said, we welcome you home. You know, and the other part of that is, and speaking of home, we know sometimes we are in communities or not in communities. We're alone doing this thing by ourselves. If you are in desire of a supportive and inclusive community where you can become more of who you desire to be in Christ, we want to invite you to become a part of City of Refuge, both locally and abroad. You are welcome here. If you have a desire to join us, please type #home in your comment section, and someone from our new members department will follow up with you to offer you an official welcome. Thank you again so much for being with us today, and may God bless your journey. May God bless your yes today. Welcome home.
We thank you for worshiping with us today. We pray that you have been encouraged, transformed, and blessed by our time together. If you are a first-time visitor, let us know in the comments section of your platform with #visitor. Are you accepting a relationship with Jesus Christ? Type #Jesus. Perhaps you'd like to become a part of the City of Refuge family. I hope you do. Enter #home. That's all you need to type. Our welcoming team will contact you shortly via Facebook Messenger to move you forward. If you're watching this service on Facebook or YouTube outside of our normal broadcast time, and you can't wait until our next live service to join, send us an email to cor.refugee@gmail.com. We welcome you home. If you'd like to partner with our ministry and aid in our efforts both locally and internationally, you can use Cash App $CORUCC/ or PayPal at paypal.me/CORUCC and text to give at 510-257-9001 and follow the prompts. Bishop A. Flunder, happy birthday, Mother Miller, and the City of Refuge Ministries want to hear from you. So please send us your prayer requests, comments, or any questions via Instagram at @RefugeeUCC, Twitter and Facebook at @CityOfRefugeUCC. I hope you were moved by Bishop Flunder's service. What would David do? Are you called by God to do things differently? I know I am. So I'm using my slingshot today. I've been empowered. Thank you, Bishop. Join us as we listen to this wonderful song entitled "What a Mighty God We Serve" by Smokey Norful.
Oh, what a mighty God, what a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
Oh, what a mighty God.
Yeah, I hear y'all.
What a mighty God we serve.
Hey,
angels bow.
Holy, holy.
Hey, God, you are my God.
You are my God. No one greater, no one greater. Everybody just
your hands together right here. Hey, 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 hey.
correct.